Hi guys, what's going on? Welcome back to this brand new Android Studio tutorial, and today in this video I'm going to quickly show you that how to make an Android browser. So as you can see, this is a sample app which is called the WebView Master, and as you can see inside the app there is a progress bar, and next to that we have an image view, and the top we have an action bar which update the title according to the page that is open inside the WebView, which is actually this area. And as you can see, next to the title we have a back button, we also have a forward button, and we have a couple other menus. So now we have the Google home page, which I'm going to search, and I'm simply searching for my name itself, so Sabith Pkc. So when I'm selecting this one, as you can see now the progress bar is moving from the 0 to 100. Also the this image view is updated with the Google favicon, which is this logo, and also we can see the action bar is updated with the WebView title. We have the back button, we have the forward button, and as you might know, the forward button will not be working because we are at the top level page. So when I click the forward button, there's nothing. You can see can't go further, there is a message, and when I just go back, you can see now it can go back. And at this point we can just go forward, and it's working perfect. So we are going to create an Android app like this, and as you can see now we have a pop-up message says, which is a dialogue, and it says that you want to exit the app or you want to stay in the app. So when you just click on the stay, then you will be inside the app itself. Otherwise, if you just click on the exit me, then it will be going to close the app. So that's our idea. So one thing I want to mention to you guys, that the back button, which is the stock Android back button, is not only working for exiting the app, it can also act as this back button. So I'm in the second page, when I click the back button it is going to the previous page, and once again when I press the back button, then it will be going to show this pop-up message. So in this video we are going to just create an Android app like this. So without any further ado, let's get started by just going to the Android Studio. So I have a sample project which is just started right now, it is called as Super Browser Pro. So at this time I'm actually using a Dracula background in my Android Studio, which I want to change into IntelliJ theme because I want to make it much clear for you guys. So I'm switching back into IntelliJ theme. Now clicking on the apply, it's taking a little time. Anyway, it's loaded. Now we have our good old Android Studio. Now what we need to do is that first off we have a we have a layout which has nothing, just going to the text. We actually have a constrained layout, which is the default layout when you start a new Android Studio project. Now I want to change this into linear layout, so I'm changing it into linear layout. And keep in mind guys, whenever you are changing your layout into linear layout, or if you are adding a new layout which is linear, then at that case, and if you're adding multiple items inside the linear layout, then you must have to add the orientation as an attribute inside the linear layout. So I'm just adding a orientation, and in this case I want to make it as vertical because I want to show items one by one. So I'm just adding it as vertical. Now removing this text view, what we need is, like the app, we have a progress bar, and next to that we have a image view. So I'm just going to create another linear layout, and linear layout, match parent, and the height can be around 30 dp. So it's all up to you, like the design of the Android app. So I'm actually doing this tutorial, and for that purpose I'm just using a sample layout. And if you have any kind of good idea, then you can go with your idea. So I want to make this into match parent both case, and after that maybe I just add a style because we need a horizontal. So I'm actually using this base widget app compact, then progress bar horizontal, and next to that we need a image view. So I'm just creating an image view and match parent. And now as you can see, it says that we need to add the orientation. So what we need to do is just add an orientation that is horizontal in this case, because we need the widgets one next to the another. So when you're using the linear layout, you will get a facility to add the weight. So that is layout weight, which I want to use in this case as 0.1, and for the image view I want to switch it into 0.9. So now as you can see, we have a view like this. It is divided into a different part according to the weight that we have given in the both case. Now I'm just going to add a sample image, so that can be the launcher, which is the app icon. Now we have it. So the next thing is that outside this linear layout and inside the main linear layout, I'm just going to create a web view that is match parent, and I don't need this tag, so I'm just closing it here. And finally, we need to add the ID for each of the items. So my web view and this image view can be ID, then my image view, and in this case I want to add it as my progress bar. Now we have it, and the next thing is that we have to declare all these items inside the main activity, which I'm just going to add outside this onCreate method. So first we have the progress bar, and that is super, just giving a sample name, super progress bar. Now we have to declare these three things inside the onCreate method. So first we have the super, then progress bar equal to then find view by ID or dot ID dot my progress bar. So I'm just going to skip this part. Okay, now I have declared three of the item inside the onCreate method. So finally, what I need to do is that it's not final, but at the next point is that we have to add the progress bar. So progress bar, then we have to set the maximum, so that can be 100. So it will be starting from 0 and ending in the 100%. So next, what we need to do is that we have the image view, we have the web view. So the next thing is that we have to add the web view. So web view, then first we need to add the load URL. In my case, I want to just give it as something like, https, then www.google.com, kind of. Okay, now it's google.com. So when the app is going to start, then it will be going to load google.com. So after that, we need to add the web view. Then it's this time you will have to enable the JavaScript. So get settings, then set enable, just set JavaScript enable, that is true. So the JavaScript is a kind of must thing that you need to add inside the web view, because most of the website these days are using JavaScript for loading some sort of items and widgets, and thereby our web view should be able to load those contents. So we need to set the JavaScript enabled. Next we have the super web view. Then at this time, most in case we use as the set web view client, and in this case we are going to use set web view client, and at the same time we are going to also use this set web Chrome client. So first off, I'm going to use the web Chrome client, which is a really good method which can help to introduce a lot of the features. So web Chrome client, it's hard to pronounce. Now I'm just opening between these two, you see this between these two brackets, I'm going to add a curly braces. So that is like this. And now inside that, what I'm going to do is that I'm just simply pressing Ctrl O on the keyboard, so it will be like this. And when I press the Ctrl O, as you can see, I have a small pop-up window on my screen, and in the window I have these three methods which I need: the one progress changer, one received title, and one received icon. And in case if you can't see these methods, then you can simply search it on the keyboard. Just simply press that. So on receiver icon and things like that. So once you got the methods, then what you need to do is that press the Ctrl on the keyboard, and by keep pressing the Ctrl, you just have to select three of them, and now you can leave the Ctrl, and just after selecting three of them, just click on the OK. Now it will bring those three methods inside the WebView client, web Chrome client. Now, as you can see, we have three methods. One is the one progress changer, which has web view, then view, and next we have the new progress, which is an integer. So what we're going to do is that we need to get the progress from this web Chrome client. So into the we are going to get the progress into the progress bar. So we have the super, then progress bar, then set progress. At this time, we have new progress, which is a variable name, which is an int type, and that's it. Now, next we have the string title, which is going to be the title for the action bar. Now, action bar can be accessed through the get support action bar. Then set title, and in this case, you just need to you can directly add the string. Now it is a title, and finally we have the bitmap icon, which is the favicon of the website or the web page. Now I want to get into my image view, so we have the super image view, then set image bitmap, and that is going to be icon, which is this variable name of the one receiver method. Now we have it. Now everything is done, and the next thing is that we have to just go to the manifest, enable the permission for using internet, so that can be internet, and yeah, okay. Now we have given the permission, and the final thing is that we have to add a couple of the things for okay, before that I'm just going to run the app, and I'm pretty sure that it will not going to run because we haven't added a single line. We haven't added one more line in this code, and that line is really significant for running the web page inside the web view. So now when the app is going to get started, I'm pretty sure that it will be going to open the URL inside the default browser, and in my case the default browser is the Google Chrome. So this is the Google Chrome. I have this is what I said as a default browser, and I will after opening the app, I will be also I'll be also explaining the reason why the app is going to start inside the way the URL is going to start inside the Chrome browser instead of our Android application. So let's wait a couple seconds until this get done. So right now it's completed building process, so hoping that it will going to start really soon. Okay, now it's installing the APK. So let's wait, and now it's opening, and as you can see it loaded, and blam, it's actually opening it inside the Chrome browser. Okay, now it's time to fix this error. So the first thing is that we're just going to back. Now as you can see, now we just added the web Chrome client method, but we forgot to add one thing, that is the super, then web view, then set web view client, and new web view client. So when you add this line, it represents that you just give the permission to just open the URL inside the web view itself, and while using this method, then it is just enabling a lot of the features inside your web view. Now when we are running the app, and then it's pretty sure that it will be going to start within the app itself. So let's wait until it's, now as you can see it's opening. Okay, now the next thing is that finally in this video, what I'm gonna do is that I'm simply showing you guys that how to go back. So before that, I'm going to search my name. Now I'm going to search it, and now I'm in the second page, and as you can see everything is updating, and now when I just go back, you can see it's going to close the application. So instead of that, we just need to go to the previous page of the web view. So for that, what I'm going to do is that simply just going to add the one back preset method, which is just stock Android method. I want to call it like that. Now inside the one back preset, we have to add a if statement and check that if the web view can go back. So we can simply say super web view, then dot can go back, and if it can go back, then it should go back, and it can be given like super web view, then go back. So in case it can't go back, then we just need to close the application. So we can simply call the finish method, which is going to destroy that activity, which is the main activity. And as we only have a single activity, then it will be going to close the application. Now let's go and try that app again. Okay, now it's running, and as you can see, now it's loading the page. Let's wait until it can and let's get done. Okay, and now it's Google. What I'm going to do is that I'm simply searching, like, you know, Sabith PKC and selecting this one. Now I'm just going to, you know, the next page, which is the YouTube, my YouTube channel. Now I'm in the YouTube channel, and we are 3 pages away, or maybe like 2 pages away from the initial page. Now I'm just going to press the back button. Oh, it's still closing the application. So what we need to do is that we just need to run the app, you know, normal run instead of this instant run. And let's try this time. Just searching, same thing. Just going to my YouTube channel. Okay, now this time everything is done. We have the activity, we have the action bar which shows the title, we have fully loaded progress bar, next to that we have a favicon. Now I'm going to press the back button. Still closing the application, so we need to check. So then it should go back other way. Oh, okay, the problem is, as you can see, I'm actually so much, yeah, it's disappointing that I haven't added this else. Now it's okay. Maybe like while you're watching this video, you might be wondering that why am I actually not going to add this else. Now I just didn't notice that. Now it will be going to work perfect, I'm pretty sure. Now let's wait until it get done. Okay, so doing the same thing without any explanation or come on, I don't know, sometimes my internet is so okay. PKC, going to my channel. Now we are 2 pages away, going back. Blam, as you can see, it's working perfect. Just going to the home page. Now we are in the home page, so it's working perfect than we expected. Now when I just press it again, it will be going to destroy that activity, which is the main activity. And as we only have a single activity, it's just going to close the application. So that's it for this video, and the next video, maybe like we are going to just add the action bar item. Like in this application, as you can see, we have the action bar, then there is a menu, there is a forward menu, then we have a couple other menus. So we are going to add these things into our Android app, and also we will be adding this dialogue in the next video. So stay tuned. As always, thanks for watching, and peace out.